बेस्ट डिसीज टुडे देर इज अ गुजरात स्थापना दिवस ओके सो टुडे इज अ फर्स्ट मे द गुजरात इज अ न्यू स्टेट मेड डिफरेंट फ्रॉम बॉम्बे महाराष्ट्र सो बेस्ट डिसीज अगेन फॉर अवर स्टेट नाउ टुडे इज माई लेक्चर ऑन अ रिकॉम्बिनेंट डीएनए इट इज अ वन पार्ट ऑफ अ मोलेक्युलर टेक्निक सो वी विल कंटिन्यू टुडे विद अ मोलेक्युलर टेक्निक We already completed the course of molecular biology of the first year MBBS. It includes purine, pyrimidine, synthesis, catabolism, DNA, RNA formation, different type of RNAs, different type of DNAs, the DNA replication, protein synthesis, transcription, post-transcriptional modification, post-translational modification, genetic code. Mutation, all have been covered. Now, this is important regarding your MCQ point of view, your PG entrance point of view, and these all are the advanced topic. Okay? So, please concentrate here. In RNA, you have been already known that there are the three types of RNA, rRNA, tRNA, and mRNA. mRNA made from a DNA, it comes to the cytoplasm from nucleus. On a rRNA ribosomes, they will attach, and where the tRNA take the amino acid will make the protein synthesis. Finally, the polypeptide chain has been done and the protein synthesis completed. But there are two different, there are the others also RNA, they are the miRNA. If mRNA is different and miRNA is different, the miRNA is called as a microRNA. Same way, there is interfering RNA or RNAi or the siRNA, brother. So, these are the different RNA. These microsomal RNA, what they do, they will silent, they will inhibit the particular mRNA. Sometimes the mRNA which are not good one, which are not required, they have been synthesized from DNA, or sometimes the mRNA they are not completely formed. So it is required that there should be no protein synthesis from that mRNA. So this is some advantage point of view also. We can use it help us in a pathological disease formation. The microRNA and miRNA are 21 to 25 base pair length. They have the RNA hairpin loop-like structure and so-called as short hairpin, shRNA. In cytoplasm, out of the two strand, one strand is broken by the Dyson nucleus. Now, please see here, the green one, it is the above. From a DNA, the purple color is a gene, it's a DNA. From DNA, there is a double-stranded, the loop-like structure, pre-miRNA has been formed. And from debranching enzyme, spliceosome, they will make certain activity. And finally, the pre-miRNA has been formed. It will come from a particular vesicle, particular pore, exporting phi to the cytoplasm. In a cytoplasm, nucleus will egg and the hairpin loop structure, it will be broken. It will be broken. Now the two strands has been there and their strands are separated. And this single strand, this will join with the particular mRNA. The last one that in a green circle, that particular single strand is then, it will join to the particular mRNA. So, the miRNA is joined to the mRNA and it will inhibit it. The selected strand is a called guide strand, which is incorporated into RNA-induced silencing complex, RISC risk, to form the functional silencer of mRNA. The microRNA bind to the matching piece of the mRNA. I have already told you that just simple things. miRNA is a one type of RNA with a 21 to 25 base pair. It is made from a DNA. Here it is initially hairpin loop like structure. From exporting phi, it will come to the cytoplasm. In a cytoplasm, that hairpin loop structure is converted into double-stranded. A double-stranded has been separated, and that miRNA will join to the mRNA and inhibit it. So the risk to form the functional silencer of mRNA, the microRNA bind to the matching piece of messenger RNA, turn it into double strand, keep it from doing its job. The process effectively blocks the production of corresponding protein, causing the translocation arrest. More than 2,500 human miRNA has been identified. Circulating miRNA is a rich source of potential disease biomarker. So, thus way, the miRNA has been helpful. Already 2,500 miRNA has been identified. And the main function of miRNA to make the silent particular mRNA, so there is no further protein synthesis. Please make it clear, the microRNA or miRNA, they are just like as a defensive to the us. They will stop the particular protein synthesis. Okay? Same way, this is the interfering RNA or the RNAi or the siRNA. Short double-stranded RNA, about 21 to 25 base pair. RNA is called as RNA interference. Faster way to turn off genes, just like as a miRNA. Both RNA and microRNA result in decreased level of the functional protein in a cell. Thus, it will helpful. One of the powerful methods for the silencing the disease-causing genes in incurable neurological disease. If you have a patient with incurable neurological disease, then with the help of siRNA or the miRNA, you can stop the particular mRNA disease functioning. So there is no disease functioning protein synthesis, and finally the protein synthesis is inhibited. Now this is a 21 to 21 base pair. In miRNA, the difference is it is also the 21 to 25 base pair. The double-stranded DNA will make the short RNA. The siRNA will in a duplex form. The disulfonuclear will make the final risk of formation is there. This is a complex, and there the double-stranded, the one single strand will join with the particular mRNA, and it will break the mRNA, so there is a silencing. Thus, here the particular hairpin loop structure is there. Here there is same way, but okay. And here the same way, the one part of shRNA will join to the particular mRNA and make it silencing. Okay. So this is a small figure. Here it will shows the how the miRNA and the siRNA, it is working. It is called as antisense therapy because they inhibit the mRNA. Here from a DNA, the mRNA formation is there. The antisense DNA, miRNA or the siRNA will form. Initially it is in a hair look like structure. Later on it is a double stranded, and finally there is a single stranded structure with a RISC complex. They will join to the particular mRNA. And that it is going to join the mRNA, either it will going to break the mRNA or join remaining. So finally there is no protein synthesis. So finally there is no disease formation is there. Okay. So this should be clear regarding miRNA or the siRNA. Please make it sure mRNA, tRNA, rRNA, these all are a constructive one. But these miRNA and siRNA, they have the inhibit phenomena. Okay? They are a part of an antisense therapy. Okay? Now, we have the few MCQ. Which of the following is not a ribozyme? The transpeptidase, ribonuclease, peptidyl transferase, and the poly-A polymerase. Already you know that peptidyl transferase and ribonuclease, they are already the ribozymes. They are a RNA, work as an enzyme, and they itself work as an enzyme. So no further enzyme is required when they act. And the poly-A, its tail, it's at the 3' end of the mRNA. On 5' end, there is a capping. So the answer is poly A polymerase. Okay, it helps at the 3 days end, so it saves the mRNA when it comes from the nucleus to the cytoplasm. It's a one type of post transcriptional modification. So please make your concept clear. The remaining three are the ribozyme. The reverse transcriptase is a different one. This is a ribozyme. Okay. Ribonuclease, peptidyl transferase and transpeptidase. Okay. Now the protein synthesis occur in the rough endoplasmic reticulum, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, both A and B and the NUG. Please make it sure that the all lipid function, whatever that molecule will make at smooth endoplasmic reticulum, but protein synthesis will make at rough endoplasmic reticulum. Okay. Whatever the lipid component, they will make at smooth endoplasmic reticulum, but all protein component are either ribosomal RNA or anything, they are made at rough endoplasmic reticulum. Participate, which of the following is participate in a protein synthesis? Ligase, helicase, peptidyl transferase or peptidase? Please make it clear that the DNA ligase and DNA helicase, they are a part of DNA replication. Peptidase, it's a dividing enzyme, and the peptidyl transferase is an enzyme to make the peptide bond formation between the two amino acids, and already the second amino acid which comes to the A site is already active. So when the translocation step, before the translocation step, the new amino acid will join the peptide bond with the old amino acid. So there is a peptide bond formation is there, and then there is a translocation is there, and the A site is come to the P site. Okay, and again new amino acid is come to the A site. So the answer is peptidyl transferase. Now the next MCQ, which of the following inhibitor the translation causes the premature chain termination? Okay, here it is with the releasing one, how that it inhibit. So erythromycin, cyclohexamide, diphtheria toxin inhibit the EF2 component. Regarding erythromycin and cyclohexamide, the one is buy at 30 and sell at 50. 80 means aminoglycosides, streptomycin and tetracycline inhibit the 30S component. CELL, cyclochloramphenicol, erythromycin, linezolid, they inhibit the 50S component. But here the puromycin, it will make the premature chain termination, as the erythromycin, cyclohexamide, diphtheria, the diphtheria inhibit the EF2 component, erythromycin inhibit the 50S component. So the answer is puromycin. And the last one, high energy phosphate required to form one of the peptide bond. 2, 4, 6 and 8. We have already told you that if there is a 10 peptide bond formation is there, peptide bond for 10 amino acid, there are already 10 into 4, 40 amino acid are there, and one for initiation and two for the initiation and the one for the releasing factor. So the next is a 3 1, so 40 plus 3 is a 43. For one amino acid, the amino acid tRNA initially activate. So there are two ATP has been used, the amino acid tRNA complex plus AMP formation. And the next two are joined when there is a elongation phase is there. At that time, the two GTP has been used. So total 4 GTP has been used. So the answer is 4. Okay. If there are 20 amino acid, then 20 into 4, it means 80 ATP has been used. So it should be the multiplication with 4. Okay. Now come to the recombinant DNA technology. This is one of the advanced technology. The biotechnology has defined the method by which the living organism or parts used to incorporate the particular character of the another living organism. Okay. One of the simple antibiotic and drug development, one of the simple use of the recombinant therapy, you already know, there is a formation of insulin. Okay, antibiotics and drug development, recombinant hormone and enzyme. Here the in cellular organism, small organism, there is a multiple copy. Yeah, insulin is joined with the E. coli, and when the E. coli multiplication, the insulin also multiply, and we remove the required insulin from the multiplied E. coli, and we get the more synthesis of the more number of the more quantity of the insulin. Drought and insect resistant crops and biofertilizer and bioinsecticides. These are the last two are the agriculture use, the initial one are the clinical use. Okay, so these are the important recombinant DNA technology. Now, in a we have already told that insulin is joined with the E. coli, but it is not a simple one. Here, the one of the important enzyme name is a restriction endonuclease. It will be used. Okay. So, there is a sequence in the E. coli or any other organism, the host sequence should be there, and it will, the restriction endonuclease enzyme cut at the specific site, okay. It is one of the equal site, the sequence which is on the upper side, the same sequence in a lower side, okay. And it will cut at the specific site, okay. In order to transfusion, it is first selectively split from a parent DNA. This is usually achieved by the restriction endonuclease. The now please concentrate, the name is endonuclease, means it is not a exonuclease. If there is a exonuclease, then it will cut at either 3' end or 5' end. But here the name is endonuclease, means there is a cleavage in the parent DNA in the internal site, which is referred to as molecular scissors. Okay, you know the scissors. Here it is called as a molecular scissors. Certain enzymes of the bacteria restrict the entry of the phages into the host bacteria, hence the name is restriction. Okay, so this is how the molecular scissors, they will act, means restriction endonuclease will act. Okay, it will act at the particular site, and they will make either the sticky end or the blunt end, okay, according to requirement, according to sequence of the our required protein, they will make the particular cutting. Okay, the sticky end will join from the upper and lower, the blunt end are the parallel to each other. In a E. coli, they will cut at this GAATTC. In HIN3, they have this sequence, Haemophilus influenza. TEC1 is a Thermus aquaticus. In HPA is a Haemophilus parainfluenza. Okay. But please, you should know at least ECOR1, HIN3, TEC1, and the HPA1 for the future PGMCQ. This is the specific restriction endonuclease that they will cut in E. coli at particular sequence, in HIN3 at particular sequence, okay. And here from that sequence, their DNA is going to open, okay. This DNA is going to open, okay. Now, please see, okay, how they will act. This is a recombinant technology with the restriction endonuclease. The ones, there is a plasmid is there. Restriction endonuclease molecular scissor, they have the cutting at particular site. The another are the donor DNA, they are also at the particular site, which are same to the plasmid, same to same. There is no single change is there. G in the upper DNA molecule, there is a G, and the lower one is a C double T double A. Okay, same sequence is there. So the donor DNA will join to the particular plasmid DNA. And then once there is a further, there is a recombinant DNA, then there is a multiple copy. This is a multiple copy, okay. And from there, when the multiple copies formation, we will cut the insulin and we will take from out, okay. So this is a restriction endonuclease. So please, you should know ECOR1, HIN3, TEC1, and the HPA1. Okay. Now, this is regarding RNA, that the total RNA are isolated containing the mRNA and the rRNA. Pass through the column of the immobilized the oligo DT, when the mRNA with the poly A tail retained in the T pairs with the A. The DNA synthesis by the reverse transcriptase and dNTPs and hybrid are produced. Okay, the sequence, they have a little bit changed, and how the DNA synthesis and the reverse transcriptase. Okay, this is a EcoR1 cut. Okay, that the EcoR1 have a sequence, it is going to cut, and the specific bacterial DNA, they will join to the EcoR1. Okay, so there is a particular formation. This is a chimeric DNA molecule by the EcoR1. The recombinant DNA is called as a chimeric DNA. Okay. This is a plasming with the carrying insert. Transfector of the vector into the host. The first one sees the E. coli bacteria growing in the ordinary medium having the malignant colonies. The second one grows in a medium containing ampicillin and tetracycline, and third with the chloramphenicol where the mark is a red circle is absent, so colony in B is selected for the further amplification. Okay, the marking colony that is for which is inhibited by the chloramphenicol but is activated by the ampicillin and tetracycline. So if you want to take any with the ampicillin and tetracycline, you can use that particular colony. Okay, otherwise it will shows, if you are going to select the colony from a C1, then it will shows there is also the resistance to chloramphenicol also. Okay, this is a DNA recombinant technology. Human mRNA is there. From we take the insulin example, there is a mRNA of the insulin, it will make the cDNA copy. The plasmid vector cleaved by the specific restricted exonuclease and vector carrying the human gene. Transformation into the host bacteria where it multiplies and they will make them a multiple copy. Selection of bacteria carrying the human gene by the antibiotic sensitivity. Okay, here these different mediums are there. Bacteria, we are going to make that recombinant DNA. So we are host bacteria where it is sensitive to the ampicillin. Okay, and selection of bacteria for a human gene by antibiotic sensitivity. Finally, there is a clone amplification, so we can isolate. And finally, there is a isolation of protein. Okay, so thus there are the importance of restriction endonuclease. The human mRNA, third is a transfection into the host bacteria, how they are selection of bacteria by the antibiotic sensitivity testing, finally the clomb amplification, finally there is isolation of protein. Okay, this is the same thing that the human cell and bacteria are there, the chromosomes and the plasmid, the isolated chromosome, human gene responsible for insulin production. Okay, the gene inserted into the plasmid, and they both are inserted into the host bacteria, and that bacteria are multiplied, and you can get there is a production of insulin. This is a simple one. Till today you know this one, but this is as a now you should know how the particular bacteria have been identified with the antibiotic sensitivity testing. Okay, now come to the CRISPR-Cas9. Okay, this is a one of the important technology. Here it is a future. The future is with the CRISPR-Cas9 technology. The CRISPR means cluster of regularly interspersed short palindromic repeats. We have completed the RNA recombinant technology. Now please come to the CRISPR-Cas9. Okay, the full you should know what is the CRISPR-Cas9. The first, the full name, cluster of regularly interspersed short palindromic repeats. Initially, the CRISPR-Cas9 has been used by the bacteria. Here, when the virus attacks the bacteria and it will RNA inside the bacteria. So, how the bacteria defend themselves? The bacteria itself produces the Cas9 protein. It is a protein inside the nucleus. It has the ribonuclease activity, and the short particular RNA is there. So that RNA will join to the viral RNA in the presence of Cas9, and that Cas9 will break that particular mRNA of virus. And now the once the mRNA has been break, so now there is no further disease progression, there is no further protein synthesis, and there is no further disease production. Thus the bacteria defends themselves. In 2013, the CRISPR-Cas9 has been used for the human. And how, why I am saying that it is for the future use? Because after 10 years, 20 years, each one is asking that please help me for this disease, please help me, because with CRISPR-Cas9 we can do in a short time gene identification, gene editing. There is a normal gene production. It is also possible to make the changes in the DNA sequence of the somatic cell. So it is for the same generation, but there are also the chances, there are also the reports that CRISPR-Cas9 helpful in a genetic cell also, okay, germinal cell also. So for the next generation, you can also the save the line, the you can save the next generation from a disease. So there are so many diseases which do not have cure, okay. So we can help, we can remove that disease, we can remove that particular the damaged DNA, so called the pathological DNA, from with the CRISPR-Cas9 technology. Okay, CRISPR and Cas protein from the CRISPR-Cas system. The CRISPR is another mechanism employed for the microbes which provide the acquired immunity against viruses and plasmid. I have already told the bacteria has been defended against the viruses and plasmid by a bacteriophage with the CRISPR-Cas9 system. The Cas9 enzyme acts like a molecular scissor, just like as a restriction endonuclease, the capable of cutting DNA strand, but it is a here DNA strand. Make it sure that CRISPR-Cas9, the CRISPR itself is a mRNA. It is not a DNA. The short DNA sequence known as the palm protospacer adjacent morsels serves as a tag present or target DNA sequence. Here, already in a translation and transcription, we have seen the shield organo sequence in a translation and Tata box in a transcription. And there are some sequence about to the starting point. Same way the palm is there. Okay, so palm is a sequence which help where the Cas9 protein is going to join and make it sure same as the particular defective DNA is not starting, or the mRNA is not going to starting from a palm, but certain downstream to the palm. Okay, so palm is just like as a Tata box or just like as a Shin-Dalgano sequence. It is some base pair away from the starting site. This is just like as a basic one. In a case of bacteria, the spaces are taken from the viruses that previously attacked the organism. Okay, the previously have the attack the organism, according to that, they will make the CRISPR-Cas9 particular mRNA. They serve as the memories which enables bacteria to recognize the viruses and fight for a future attack. Okay, with the CRISPR now possible to modify, delete, insert, activate or inactivate the gene, and it is in a short time. Okay, so this is the most important thing, how it is helpful in a future use. Okay. CRISPR can be combined with the gene therapy so that modified gene can be delivered anywhere in a body. This is for a somatic one, but there are also reports that it can use in a germinal cell also. One Chinese scientist has says that he has changed particular DNA sequence which can resist against the HIV in a twin, a girl's twins in a germinal cell. Okay, but there are so many questions later on, but we are not going to make the debate regarding the Chinese scientists, but please make it sure that CRISPR-Cas9 is a helpful for a gene editing, modification, insert or deletion. Okay, this is a how they will act. The Cas9 is a one type of a protein with a ribonuclease activity. Just like as a translation, the all activity is done at ribosome in a transcription, that the all activity is done at a particular RNA protein. Okay, so the same way the Cas9 is joined, it is joined by the identification of the palm sequence. From palm sequence, the Cas9 will join in the 3' and the green one is the CRISPR RNA. Okay, it is the RNA, make it sure, which is going to bind to the DNA, and that RNA will join to the particular sequence on a DNA. Now the black and the yellow, they sequence are parallel to each other, and that sequence are cutted by the Cas9. At that time it works as a restriction endonuclease, there are the work as a molecular scissor, and that defective part of the black DNA has been removed. Okay, so double strand break by the Cas and gene correction and insertion, and finally joined by the ligation. Okay, and the DNA with without disease sequence has been modified. Okay, a duplex of the CRISPR RNA and the TRACER RNA to guide the RNA introduce a specific located gene modification upstream to the crRNA. The Cas9 binds to the spread RNA, needs the DNA binding sequence for the PAM. The Cas9 identifies the PAM and it is joined to the particular DNA. After binding, the Cas9 produces the DNA double strand break, which is then following the gene modification, homologous or non-homologous end joining. Already this has been told regarding homologous recombination or non-homologous in the DNA repair. So this is a simple one. The green one is a CRISPR RNA and the Cas9 is a protein. It is inside the nucleus. So Cas9 will join to the target DNA with the palm sequence downstream away from that particular pathologic DNA, and that the CRISPR RNA will join to the DNA pathological sequence, that black and the yellow, and the post strand of DNA has been cut by the Cas9, and now the new nucleotide, the new sequence will come and they will join, and the DNA has been modified. So gene correction and the insertion has been done. Okay, this is regarding CRISPR Cas9. Please, for a future PG MCQ, you should prepare the CRISPR Cas9 system. Okay? Now, the different types of cloning and the size has been inserted by the DNA. The types of the vector, the starting from the plasmid, bacteriophage, cosmid, YSE, yeast, and the finally bacteria. Okay? The most big one is the yeast. The plasmid is 0.5 to 8 kilo base pair, bacteriophage up to 25 kilo base pair, the cosmid up to the 45 kilo KB, the BSE up to 300 and the YSE up to the 1000 or 3000 base pair. This has been important for the PGMCQ. Okay, that this is a simple one. If you want to make the small DNA replication, then you can use the plasmid. If you want to make the bigger strand of DNA replication, same way, according to DNA sequence, if there is a big sequence, then you can use the cosmid, BSE or YSE. But please make it sure the maximum has been used by the plasmid, and the most versatile is a cosmid and the plasmid. Okay, so plasmid and cosmid are widely used. Okay. Now the come to the next technique, it is RFLP, restriction fragment length polymorphism. Here it exploits the variation in the homologous DNA sequence known as a polymorphism in order to distinguish individual population species or pinpoint location of the gene within a sequence. Here the difference between the PCR and the RFLP, the PCR is a polymerase chain reaction. Here the difference is the DNA between the people that can be recognized by the restriction enzyme. How it will act? First, there is a DNA extraction, the PCR with a loaded primer. Then there is a restriction enzyme has been cut at multiplication. In this step, there is a PCR, there is a multiplication, but here we are using particular restriction enzymes. The steps of the RFLP are the isolate DNA, perform the PCR, perform the restriction diagenase, sample analysis, capillary electrophoresis, and the analysis data. First, simple one, PCR done, restriction enzyme, final electrophoresis. Here it will show what is the variation. Okay? So, the PCR stands for the polymerase chain reaction, a molecular genetics that permits the analysis of any short sequence of the RNA or DNA without having the clone it. It just multiplication, it will not show any variation. But here, the restriction enzyme are the particular sequence are there, and that particular fragment length, what is the changes, it is called as a polymorphism. Okay, that has been identified. The unique RFLP pattern, the restriction fragment length technique cuts the gene which are likely to differentiating factor using the restriction enzyme, are separated by the gel electrophoresis, and pattern is particularly unique because there is more variability in gene examined. Okay, you can see this is a one in a sickle cell anemia, how the pattern is been different from the people to people, and it will show the RFLP pattern. RFLP has the many uses. You can first multiplication with the PCR, then RFLP enzyme, and from enzyme, what is the analysis? You can do the disease diagnosis, genetic mapping, forensic science, genetically modified organism, paternity testing, personal identification, plant breeding, the characteristics of genetic diversity, species identification. Plus, please make it sure RFLP is not an editing technique. You cannot make the editing, deletion, insertion. You can just identify. Bus. You can just identify, you can just make what are the changes there. You can just identify the changes. You can just identify the polymorphism, nothing else. Okay, in a PCR, there is continuous multiplication. So, you cannot identify even if that also. But in RFLP, you can identify just what is a change in a sequence with non-restriction and endonuclease enzyme. You can just know the restriction, non-restriction enzyme, that how many variations is there in a particular person. Okay? So, this is regarding RFLP. So, thank you for today's class. Thank you very much. Okay?